Divide the rational expressions. Problem number 5. Again, in this problem, we are dividing rational expressions, so we have to factor each individual part, use the rule for keep, change the sign to multiplication and flip, and then cross-simplify everything possible. So let's start by factoring this top problem. I don't see a greatest common factor. So this would be a trinomial with a coefficient larger than 1. So I am going to use the method of multiplying the first by itself and the last number also by the first. I'm just going to rewrite my problem now. So 3 times 3 is 9x squared minus 14x and plus 24. Now, I use the same steps as before for a trinomial with a coefficient of 1. So I'm square rooting this first term, which gives me 3x and 3x. I'm bringing down my first sign, which is a minus. Multiplying the signs together, negative times positive is a negative. And finding the factors of 24 of the last number when I have the same signs. So two negatives or two positives, the factors must add to give me the middle number, which is 14. So the only factors that will add to give me 14 is 12 and 2, because 12 times 2 is 24 and 12 plus 2 is 14. So the larger one of the two factors goes first and the smaller one second. And now, because we had multiplied by 3 in the beginning, we have to divide by 3 at the end. And only one of these two sides is divisible by 3, which is this side, and the other one by 1, because 3 times 1 gives me the 3. Sometimes you will have to split these two, but in this case, 3 is a prime number, so you can't split. And there's only one way of doing that, but hopefully we have another problem later on that I can explain that a little better. So after dividing, I am left with x minus 4 and 3x minus 2. Okay, so now we can move on to the bottom, to factor the bottom. These are two terms and both of them are perfect squares with the minus sign in the middle. So this is the difference of two perfect squares. And I'm going to use this factoring method. So square rooting the first term, which gives me x and x, a plus and a minus. And the square root of 16 is 4 and 4. Now, moving on to this part and looking at this, I see that both of these terms have a common factor, which is 9. So after taking out a 9, I'm left with 3x minus 2. And then the bottom one, 5x plus 20, also they share a common factor, which is 5. So pulling out the 5, I'm left with x plus 4. So there's nothing else I can factor now. I'm just going to rewrite my problem. So keep the first fraction. X plus 4 and x minus 4. Change the sign to multiplication and then flip the second fraction. So 5x plus 4 is now on top and 9, 3x minus 2 is in the bottom. And we can start cross-canceling. So starting here with x minus 4 on top and bottom, 3x minus 2 top and bottom, x plus 4 top and bottom, and 5 and 9 don't share a common factor. So putting together what's left, is 5 over 9. That is the solution of this problem.